Hey, welcome back. It's Money Monday. You're watching Liquid Lunch. I'm John Tobacco. Of course, I'm joined by Frankie, who's holding down the mothership today as I'm on the road. And I'm joined again by a great friend of Liquid Lunch and mine and Frank's, Scott Lobato, joined us. He's an activist, a patriotic artist, and a small business owner, as he's part of the team here at the Cargo Cafe. And Scott, during the break, we were just talking about it, that you know, there's mixed messages coming for small businesses, right? The mayor's office sends out this letter, they're stopping fees on sidewalk cafes, it's okay to serve drinks, and then the cops are actually giving you a hard time, so there's no good source of news.
No, again, it's not the NYPD, it was the sheriff. It was the sheriff that got the call from 311 that, you know, you can complain. People can rat you out. If there's a huge group of people, I'm ratting them out. It wasn't. We had sectioned off. So, look, this city, this mayor, this never did and does not represent the people. He thinks that a guy like Eddie, or the guy that owns the florist down the street, he owns a business, he's a millionaire. He's rich.
Yeah, that's true.
He's rich. That's what it is. So it's like he has no respect for what keeps this, the whole country going is the small business. And look, it's been enough. I understand this is the epicenter. I'm watching it. It's dropping. People are going nuts. This isn't just happening here at the Cargo. It's happening across the country.
Frankie, the whole thing was, all right, stay home and slow the spread. Then it was, we got to flatten the curve. We slowed the spread. We flattened the curve. And now it just, to me, seems like government is calling balls and strikes on what businesses they deem are.
Well, right. You're right. First of all, both of the things that you just said are correct. One is, yeah, they do keep moving the goalposts as to when we'll be reopening. But two, yeah, what's an essential business? As best I can tell, government will make you an essential business if enough people complain that they want you to be an essential business. Remember, in some states, gun stores are an essential business. Some states are not. Some states, everywhere, I think, liquor stores are. Golf courses were essential in some areas, not essential in others. Now here in New York, golf courses are essential, which they weren't before. So it seems like you just need enough people to scream and complain, and eventually politicians will come about to your way of thinking. But, you know, a story, a subject that we brought up with Derek Tobacco, our man on the street during the break, Scott, is given the fact that we want people to go outside and not be cooped up inside all day, and given the fact that restaurants are able to deliver cocktails now and they're struggling to stay in business and so much of their revenue comes from alcohol sales, I would urge all the lawmakers in New York, New Jersey, and around the country to suspend temporarily, at least, the open container law and allow people to drink openly on the streets.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that was what the cops were bothering you about, right?
Not really, but that was the sheriff. Not the cop. The sheriff. He was just looking for any excuse to be the big dog on campus, you know. And what is the sheriff doing here? Are they supposed to be here? I don't know.
No, well,
because the NYPD were fine with what we were doing.
I don't think most of our audience even knows what the New York City Sheriff's Office does. I think most people didn't even know that we had sheriffs in New York City.
They're courts. It's a court.
Yeah, it's not like a small town where he's the sheriff. The sheriff's office, and Frankie, I did some homework on it. What they're typically charged with is, you know, absconding people's cars,
right,
if they have too many parking tickets.
They can't arrest you.
Evicting a tenant if the court's already ordered that they should be evicted and they won't move. Another thing, they're supposed to be out there looking for people who are selling illegal cigarettes, you know, out-of-state cigarettes without the New York tax stamp. So you got the government, you got de Blasio redirecting people who, this is not part of their job to go and bust bars, chops.
Now, when the sheriff came in there, did he have spurs on his shoes and a cowboy hat? Was he dressed for the part?
I think he thought he did.
He had the attitude like he had spurs.
I talked to my lawyer, and he said, sheriff can't arrest you. They have to call the NYPD if there's a major problem to have you arrested. Right. This guy looked like he was ready to, you know, bring him to the gallows.
I can imagine.
It was just a great point that we made.
No, well, good for you. I hope they're able to stay open and be able to serve people. All right. Just aside from, well, somewhat related to the issue of the economy, it's no secret that the economy is struggling. As John pointed out at the top of the show, Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell was on 60 Minutes yesterday. He said we could be approaching 25% unemployment, numbers that we've never seen before, even during the Great Depression. I'm curious, both of you, we have an election in 6 months. At the national level and all the way down to the local level, what impact do you see the economic downturn having on the election?
Personally, I look as an artist and as a social person, I look at the whole aspect of what makes, you know, what's going to make this election. And yeah, a big part of it is the economy. But again, people are going to vote for Donald Trump, okay, because he knows, and he's promised, he knows he'll get this economy back. He knows he can do it. Okay, and I have faith that he will do it because he did it before. Unfathomable what he did. And I have faith that he's going to do it again. But of course, you're going to have the big wall of the Congress and those who just want to see this guy fail. They are living in jello, loving that this economy is in the tubes. You know, it's sad to bring this up at this point, but it's the truth.
I would love to live in jello. I've never heard that one before. That's not the worst thing I've ever heard. But Frankie, here's what I think. I think the economy was the number one hammer that Trump had. Look at my economy. Look at my market, okay? So there's no question that the left wants to drag this out as long as possible. You had Barack Obama yesterday doing college commencement speeches online and taking the time out of a joyous day for kids to actually start attacking the sitting president, saying he clearly doesn't know what he's doing. So this is war. And I think Trump's going to be able to demonstrate that we can start to come back from this. I think people have long memories when they look back and say, hey, this is what the guy did when there was no pandemic. And finally, the best thing that could have happened to Donald Trump, even with this, was that Joe Biden is his opponent and they can't do anything with him but hide him in his basement and let him keep putting his foot in his mouth every day. So that's helping Trump.
Well, let me ask you about Joe Biden. Today, the Attorney General Bill Barr came out and he was very, very frustrated with what he viewed as unfair treatment by the Obama administration's Justice Department of the Trump campaign. But he said today that while he's going to investigate the origins of this Russia probe, he doesn't expect any charges for either Barack Obama or Joe Biden. Is this at all a surprise for you, for either of you?
No,
I don't think so. Not at all. I don't think so. We never see the people at the top get slammed by the government. Never.
Why? Because 90% of the media hates Trump, always is on the side of the Democrats. We're used to it. It doesn't even make me sick anymore because the people rose up in 2006 and voted for him when everybody was against him, and they're going to do it again. They don't listen to the media anymore, the mainstream media. The CNN.
Yeah,
I'm confident.
It's certainly going to be interesting to see where we go with all this. Scott, I want to thank you for not only lending us your passion and your talent for a few minutes, but for lending us some of your substantial social media following who have been watching us in droves since you joined us. So appreciate it. I hope you'll come back again soon.
Yeah, a little later on, we're doing some good stuff with some local business owners that I'll bring everybody up to speed on tomorrow. Are we in a break?
No, we still have a minute here, John. Perhaps I can ask you, since you're a sports enthusiast yourself, Governor Cuomo says today that he wants professional sports back in New York State, and he's encouraging major sports teams to plan to reopen without fans. He says the games could be televised and that New York would help the major sports franchises. He said that whoever can reopen, including hockey, baseball, basketball, football, whatever, the state is ready, willing, and able to be a partner. How soon until we see sports without fans here in New York?
Well, I hope it's soon because I think people would just like to see some competition. But I'm sitting here in a local business with a piece of paper to the owner from the mayor. It says, hey, partner. And I don't like when the government uses terms like want to be partner because your partner shares the wins and the losses. Governor Cuomo gave himself a fat raise, just like all the people in Congress gave themselves a fat raise during this whole thing. So partners usually share in the good and the bad, and opening sports with no people in the stands. Doesn't sound like a lot of money to the owners, but it may be something on their TV contract. So I hope so.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. That's, I think, when the sheriff came into cargo, that's what he said to everybody. He said, "Howdy, partner," as he marched in with his spurs and cowboy hat. It was quite a scene. All right. I think we have to take a break. When we come back, maybe we can get into this Georgia situation in terms of this the shooting. Maybe we can talk a little bit about what the stock market is doing today, or the fact that one presidential candidate that was running that had gotten a lot of media attention, at least in comparison to other third-party candidates, has already dropped out. We'll tell you about that when we come back. Folks, you are welcome to stay with us. Frank Moreno here with John Tobacco. You're watching Liquid Lunch on Biz TV.